Hello you magnificent people, this is Chris from Recombu and I'm here with Sony's Xperia XA2, freshly launched at CES out in sunny Las Vegas just this January. It's hitting the UK in February for a price of £300 and it is of course the follow on from last year's Sony Xperia XA1, still a gorgeous little handset, great value for money, great camera tech and all the rest. We're doing the full long term review of that right now, but for now let's concentrate on the XA2. We're going to do full unboxing, setup and get it all working and so you can check it out for yourself. Now it comes in a number of different finishes. We appear to have the silver model here, very nice and shiny. It actually comes in silver, black, blue and pink. Those are your four colour options. Gotta admit, I was holding out for blue or pink. Those are very, very, very nice, vibrant shades. But silver is also lovely and sleek as well. We'll just peel off this protective sticker here on the bottom. And as you can see, there's not a massive amount of difference in terms of the design compared with last year's Xperia XA1. We'll of course do a full comparison, so stay tuned for that. Looks like it's got a bit of screen protector action on the go at the moment. We'll just leave that on for now. And let's have a bit of a tour of the box and then we'll check out the phone itself. So I'm guessing it'll be your standard Sony box. You've got your warranty and startup guides, nothing particularly exciting there. And then you've got your USB cable. Again, actually charged up, always handy. And it looks like they haven't actually given me a 3-pin plug. Oh, thanks, Sony. Cheers, guys. But luckily, being a phone reviewer, I've got about 20,000 of them stacked in a box under my bed. So that's all good. And hopefully, it'll have a bit of power to begin with anyway. Let's just try holding down that power button. Yes. There we go, it springs into life, so we can get it all set up. Sony Mobile has started 2018 on a very strong foot, thanks to the excellent Xperia XA2 smartphone. This great value blow boasts a 23 megapixel rear camera, some well-considered software and excellent battery life, all for the low asking price at just £299 here in the UK. Here's our full Sony Xperia XA2 review. When it comes to design, I instantly fell in love with the Xperia XA2. Plucking it out of the box, I was surprised by the weight of this thing. This really is one hefty blower, which definitely gives it a more premium feel than many other mid-range mobiles. Likewise, Sony has added some nice detail into that aluminium edging, which elevates it above most of its brethren. Even that polycarbonate back doesn't detract from the overall finish, although you'll definitely need to be a bit careful as it does scratch easily. And this is a pleasingly comfortable handset to hold and use as well. The Xperia XA2 boasts a slightly bigger display than the XA1 and yet is more or less the same size thanks to a narrowing of those top and bottom bezels. I certainly didn't struggle to use the phone one-handed. And Sony's smartphone also sports a pleasingly curved chassis which sits perfectly in your palm. The older Xperia XA1 didn't offer any kind of fingerprint security, but that's all changed for the Xperia XA2. In a first for Sony Mobile, this Xperia handset sports a scanner right there on the back plate. We always quite liked the edge-mounted fingerprint scanner found in more premium Sony smartphones, and yet this repositioning makes perfect sense. For one, it's more comfortable experience for left-handed users. And although this isn't the fastest scanner around, we're more than happy with the accuracy levels. Rarely did I have to tap my digits twice to unlock the Xperia XA2. That 5.2-inch IPS screen is another belter from Sony, which of course is no great surprise. Tap on the super vivid mode in the display settings and you'll enjoy quite punchy colour reproduction, while the full HD resolution helps to keep everything nice and sharp. Photos and high def movies look fantastic, although anyone who watches a lot of video on the move should maybe consider the Xperia XA2 Ultra instead. This 6-inch smartphone packs a much more spacious screen for more comfortable viewing. Audio is another highlight here. Sony software helps to boost the quality of your downloaded tracks, if you allow it to, while manual controls are also available. And while the built-in speaker is decidedly tinny, you can connect headphones via Bluetooth 5 or that 3.5mm jack. As for storage, you get a pretty basic 32 gigs of space packed inside the XA2. However, almost half of this is admittedly used up by Android and Sony's apps, so you'll likely be struggling quite soon if you download a lot of songs and movies. Don't fret though, Sony has included micro SD memory card support so you can quickly and easily expand the available space. Cards of up to 256 gigs are accepted, giving plenty of room for a massive media collection. And while we're still waiting for the latest version of Google's Android OS on that old XA1 handset, impatient types could grab the Xperia XA2 instead. Android Oreo comes packed straight onto the phone out of the box, no hanging around. Of course, Sony has added its own lick of paint on top of Android as usual. The Sony Mobile overlay changes the look and feel of your desktops and icons, although it remains customizable as ever. In addition, you get some bonus features which are, for the most part, genuinely useful. For example, the one-handed mode has now migrated from the bigger Ultra models down to the Xperia XA2. And while it's obviously much less essential on this handset, it is still definitely very nice to have. Sadly, there's no support for PS4 remote play just yet, which allows you to get a bit of gaming on the go while you're on the bogs. Instead, you simply get that second screen functionality, which is no great shakes. However, at least there are some very helpful built-in guides for Xperia noobs to help them quickly get to grips with the handset. Here's some of our favourite new features in our tips and tricks guide. How to change the look of your Xperia XA2 desktops. Just give a little pinch of your fingers when you're actually on those desktops and you'll open up this nifty hidden menu. And from here you can completely personalise the look and feel of your Xperia XA2. So for instance, you can chuck in some widgets like a handy calendar app, something like that. You can change the wallpapers or even add a whole new Sony theme, though we actually quite like this Live in Images type one that you get pre-installed. Back in there, you can even change the transitions as you're flipping around on your desktops. And one of our favourites, you can actually change the grid size as well, so you can get more or less apps packed away there on your desktops. Definitely very handy indeed. And then if you tap the settings icon, you can actually change the look and feel of your icons. You can get some new icon appearance packs downloaded, change up how they exactly they're ordered, and even remove that Google feed as well if you're not a particular fan. How to boost the Xperia XA2's display. Now by default, the Xperia XA2's 5.2-inch screen produces quite sort of natural looking images, definitely good looking stuff. However, if you would like a bit of a colour boost, just dive into the display settings and then go to colour gamut and contrast, and you'll see Sony's super vivid mode tucked away in there. Now just give that a quick tap and you'll notice from the example photo that those colours are really just boosted, giving them a nice vibrant finish. They look nice and rich, and that's our own personal preferred setting. How to make one-handed use even easier. Now we really like the look and feel of Sony's Xperia XA2 and all Sony mobiles to be fair. They're very unique with this sort of almost candy bar rectangular design. Unfortunately, those thick bottom bezels mean that you can sometimes struggle with one-handed use, especially when stretching all the way up to the top of the screen. The corner just kind of dig in a little bit. And that's especially true if you're rocking the rather massive Ultra handset. It's a 6-inch beast, so one-handed use can be a bit tricky. But thankfully, the Japanese giant has thrown in a little bit of help in this regard in both the XA2 and the XA2 Ultra. All you need to do is go into the settings again and dodge down to one-handed operations, and there's a few different bits you can get there. For instance, you can resize the screen just by flicking your thumb up from the corner to the middle. There you go. You can reorient it as well, left or right, depending on whether you're a lefty or a righty. And you can do all of your usual shenanigans in here, play around on your desktops, load up an app, and so on. And when you're done, all you need to do is just tap in that nice little black border, and it's returned to normal. Dive back into one-handed operations, you can also tick this optimized app section, and then that just adds a few extra bonus features. So for instance, whenever you're unlocking the screen, the pin entry tab will then be pushed off to the side. So again, it just makes it that little bit easier to enter your number. Get longer battery life from the Xperia XA2. Now the XA2 packs a rather massive 3,300 mAh battery, definitely a big sell for the size of the phone. And if you get the Ultra model, then you get an even bigger battery, which is always great. But you might forget to charge it overnight and find yourself running low on juice. In which case, all you need to do is dive into the settings and then head to the battery section. In here, you'll be able to see exactly how your battery usage is going. You'll be able to see what has been sapping the battery, which is always handy if you find yourself running low earlier than expected. And of course, in here, you've got the power saving modes, which Sony has chucked in as well. So for instance, you've got the stamina mode, which is your bog standard basic one. You can turn it on manually, or you can actually activate it at a specific percentage. So for instance, if you hit 30%, you can have it turning on automatically. Definitely a handy little feature. And all this does is it just knocks off some of those features that you really don't need. It's not essential stuff. It's things like GPS when you're not actually using the phone, and automatic push notifications as well. You'll have to actually manually reload your emails, things like that, when this is activated. And then if you're really struggling and you want to get the absolute most out of those final dregs, then dive into the Ultra Stamina mode. This basically calls all but the most essential features. As you see, you'll be able to make calls, you'll be able to text your friends, and you'll even be able to use the camera so you can get a selfie on the go if you really need to. Although if you're running down to about 3%, we probably advise you not to do that. And that is also available at any time. How to connect to your PS4. Now, because it's a Sony phone, of course, there is some PlayStation functionality in there in the form of the PlayStation app. You'll find this pre-installed on your phone when you first get it. All you need to do is just give that a quick tap, and then load in your PlayStation ID and your password, and you'll get connected to the PlayStation network in that way. You'll get this nice little sort of stream of all of your PlayStation news. You can also check out your friends and follow some new people. You've got all your notifications and everything as well. And if you tap this big blue button at the bottom here, then you get loads of extra functionalities. For instance, you see any upcoming events. Check out your trophies if you want to like show off to your mates or anything like that. Redeem some codes, and you've got full access to the likes of the PlayStation Store and your PS Plus account as well, all via that online hub. So that's a nice little feature. There is some bonus stuff as well, such as the second screen feature, which actually allows you to directly hook up your phone to your PlayStation and then use it to, for instance, enter a code using the virtual keyboard on your phone rather than on the PS4 using the controller, which is a bit awkward. We're going to do a full explainer video about the second screen because we still get asked about it a fair bit, so stay tuned for that. Check out Sony's own Xperia XA2 tips and tricks. Now, you might be new to Sony phones or even Android phones in general, in which case you might need a little bit of extra help on top of this video, in which case just dive into the settings, and Sony has rather helpfully added this assist functionality. Dive into there. As you can see, there's an introduction to Xperia right at the top. And what this basically is, it's a bunch of virtual guides which just show you some of the essential features on the Xperia XA2, how to use the camera, how to set up the fingerprint sensor, all that kind of stuff. It's a really, really helpful little feature if you are new to smartphones in general. You've also got Xperia Tips, which basically learn how you use the phone and then offer little bits of advice. Your Xperia Actions basically just allows you to set up a bunch of themes based on what you're doing at the time. Definitely worth a check of that. Stamina Mode we've already covered, it's the power stuff. Smart Cleaner is on by default, and that basically just helps to clear your cache and means you've got plenty of storage for all of your apps and media. And then Battery Care, you don't need to worry about that. It's just about the Qnovo tech which is packed in there, which helps prevent long-term damage. And if you're still struggling and need a bit of help, then dive into support right at the very bottom of the settings. And from here, you can get access to all kinds of topics. You can actually access a forum, which gives you some more advice, and you can get some direct feedback from Sony users and some of the Sony people themselves. And also there's a contact us section if you're really, really struggling. Previous cut price Sony phones have come packing a MediaTek processor, which usually provides quite basic performance. However, for the Xperia XA2, we get an upgrade to Qualcomm's Snapdragon 630 chipset. This is made for mid-range mobiles, and it's backed here by 3 GB of RAM. When Antutu do benchmark and tests don't show a huge improvement over the XA1, we found that the XA2 ran quite smoothly in everyday life. Yeah, we did see a couple of little stutters here and there, but certainly nothing too disagreeable. And best of all, fast-paced action games run with a dependable frame rate. And battery life is even better. Sony has stuffed a mighty 3,300 mAh cell inside of the XA2, which probably helps to account for that heft. And as a result, I always got well over a day of life between charges, as long as you don't abuse the heck out of the phone. In fact, you can even stretch to 2 full days of playtime if you're a bit more careful. And if you do somehow find yourself running low on juice, Sony has kindly included 2 stamina modes to help out. These called non-essential features, extending that remaining running time. And when you eventually do plug in the XA2, Qualcomm's Quick Charge 3.0 means you'll be back up to full power in just over an hour. And as usual, you also find that helpful Qnovo tech on board, which helps to prevent the battery from overcharging. So over time, you therefore shouldn't see any degradation in performance. Now, slapped on the back of the Xperia XA2 is another great Sony mobile camera. Like the Xperia XA1, this is a 23 megapixel shooter with an XMORe RS lens, all of Sony's own creation. However, while the specs are very similar, you can expect a fair few improvements here. That 23 megapixel camera slapped on the back of the Xperia XA2 and the Xperia XA2 Ultra is some of the best mobile shooting tech you'll find at this sort of price point. We've been test driving both of these phones, and here's our full XA2 and XA2 Ultra camera reviews. On paper, the Xperia XA2 camera tech seems identical to last year's Xperia XA1. You once again have a single lens 23MP shooter on that back end, complete with Sony's XMORe RS sensor. And meanwhile, around the front is an 8MP selfie camera for snapping your beautiful mug. However, that low light sensor has been updated in the preceding 12 months, which should, in theory at least, mean better night shots and shots in low light environments such as dingy bars and restaurants. Flick to the video mode and you'll notice a new feature on the Xperia XA2. That slick slow motion mode allows you to shoot a
video at 120 frames per second and then edit it afterwards to add in a slow motion effect. This can only be applied to a single section sadly, and it can't quite match the incredible results from Sony's super slow motion capture, which is found only on more premium Xperias. However, it's still a great addition here and can produce some awesome results. Likewise, the Xperia XA2 also offers up more shooting settings for standard home movies. For instance, you can now record full HD video at a massive 60 frames per second for a much more realistic feel, or even bump up to full 4K Ultra HD resolution. With decent lighting conditions, the Xperia XA2's rear camera certainly doesn't disappoint. By default, you'll shoot 20 megapixel images with a 16:9 aspect ratio, so our test photos pack plenty of detail when blown up onto a full tele screen. You can also expect quite natural color reproduction rather than a bunch of overly processed hues. And for the most part, scenes with any tricky contrast are generally well handled. Only very bright skies and the light prove a problem, with some slight oversaturation occurring. Low light snaps have their own limitations, with a wee bit of grain creeping in when things start to get really dark. However, keep a steady hand and you can often get a usable shot. Just make sure your subject stays still as well, or you will end up with a bit of a headache inducing blur. Selfies taken with the standard Xperia XA2's 8 megapixel front facing camera are also prone to a little bit of oversaturation and can be blotchy or blurry in low light. However, that wide angle lens means you can capture plenty of scenery or a group of mates in just one shot. And if you go for the Ultra model, you can swap between that lens and a secondary 16 megapixel snapper. This doesn't have quite the same wide angle benefit, so the view is a bit more limited, but it does have a bit of built-in optical image stabilization, which means it's much better suited to taking on photos in dim conditions. And video quality is decent for this kind of price point too. The Xperia XA2 captures reasonably sharp full HD movies, with the lens quickly snapping onto your subjects and keeping them in focus. And you can freely move and shoot as well, as the steady shot image stabilization really helps to cut down on shudders and shimmers. If you bump the full HD frame rate up to 60 frames per second, you'll probably want to stand a bit more still. That steady shot feature isn't available with those settings. However, that fluid finish gives a more realistic result, and our footage did come out well, as long as we stood quite still. The Xperia XA2 also offers the option of shooting at 4K. That's still relatively rare at this price point, so it's great to see on Sony's mid-range mobile. Results are again quite solid, with some basic digital stabilization, again reducing those tremors as you move about the place. The Xperia XA2 is a great little tool for shooting your everyday existence, especially if you're on a tightish budget. Only the low light functionality really disappointed, especially if your subject is moving, but everything else came out really nicely indeed, and the ability to shoot at 4K resolution is fantastic. As much as I love that old Xperia XA1, the XA2 is a massive upgrade in several key areas. The design has been reworked for a more premium finish, while that impressive battery life and gorgeous display also boost this phone over most other mid-ranges. For just 300 quid here in the UK, you really won't find many other mobiles that offer that same fantastic all-round experience. We've got loads more videos on the Xperia XA2, including a full unboxing, tips and tricks, and loads more, so go check those out. Don't forget to give us a like and a subscribe, and ding that notifications bell. Thanks for watching.